In part 3 of our lesson on translations of sine and cosine, we are going to graph a cosine function. In this example, we are being asked to sketch one cycle of y equals 3 cosine of the quantity 2x plus pi over 2 plus 1. Let's check your understanding. So pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. We know that one of the first things we want to do is rewrite the function into the standard form where the argument is factored. So this is going to become 3 times the cosine. We'll factor out the 2 and think of dividing by 2 on the inside now, or multiplying by 1/2. So the 2x, if I multiply by 1/2, will become x. The pi over 2, if I multiply by 1/2, will become pi over 4. And then we still have the plus 1. The period is found by 2 pi over b. We know that b is equal to 2. We have 2 pi over 2, which is equal to pi. So this is going to be a horizontal compression. The graph is going to be going twice as fast. All the x values will be divided by 2 from the normal cosine graph. Amplitude is the absolute value of A. We know that A is equal to 3, so we're doing the absolute value of 3, which is 3. Phase shift is equal to C. And remember, to be careful, C is what comes after a minus sign. So you have to think of this argument as x minus a negative pi over 4. So when there's a plus sign here, don't make that common mistake of thinking c is positive. When there's a plus sign in here, that actually means that c had to be negative. So c is negative pi over 4. Make sure you include the negative sign. And because c is negative, that means we will have a shift to the left. The vertical shift is equal to d. And in this case, d is a positive 1. So that means the graph will be moving upward. The domain, it's a cosine, so we know its domain is all real numbers, so negative infinity to positive infinity. The range, we start off knowing that every cosine has a range of negative 1 to 1 if it's unaltered, and this graph is being altered by an amplitude of 3, so that would turn this into negative 3 to 3, and then it has a vertical shift of positive 1, which means it's going up 1. So if we're at negative 3 and we go up by 1, we would be at negative 2. If we're at positive 3 and we go up by 1, we'll be at 4. So we expect our graph to have a range of negative 2 to 4. Next, we're going to solve the inequality to find the shifted cycle. And we know that for a cosine graph, we have to take the argument and put it in between 0 and 2 pi, we can use either form of the argument, the factored form or the unfactored form. I like to use the original unfactored form. I think the algebra is a little bit easier. So we have 0 is less than or equal to 2x plus pi over 2, which is less than or equal to 2 pi. So we know we'll need to subtract pi over 2 from each of the three pieces of the inequality. The left-hand piece becomes negative pi over 2. The middle piece, the pi over 2's will cancel out, and we have 2x. And the right-hand side, we have to get a common denominator. We know that 2 pi is equal to 4 pi over 2. So if we have 4 pi over 2 and we're subtracting 1 pi over 2, we are at 3 pi over 2. Now, to get the x by itself, we're going to divide by 2, or we can think of it as multiplying by 1/2. And so, of course, we'll do the same thing to all three pieces of the inequality. And we get negative pi over 4 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 3 pi over 4. And we know that that means that the graph is going to start at negative pi over 4 and end at 3 pi over 4. And we can check the period here by subtracting 3 pi over 4 minus negative pi over 4. That would be 4 pi over 4, which of course is pi. And that's exactly what we said that the period would be. So we're feeling pretty confident. We can move forward with our graphing and now find the five key values. So from our inequality, we know our starting x value is going to be negative pi over 4, and our ending x value is going to be 3 pi over 4. So next, we have to find the midpoint, and we know to find the midpoint, you add up the start and the end and divide by 2. So I'm going to multiply by 1/2 instead of divide by 2. We have negative pi over 4 plus 3 pi over 4. So we're going to take 1/2 times. Well, this would be 2 pi over 4. And 1/2 of 2 pi over 4 is pi over 4. Now, halfway between negative pi over 4 and positive pi over 4 is going to be 0. We don't really have to take the time to calculate that one. Between pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4, right? This is 1 pi over 4. This is 3 pi over 4. So halfway between would be 2 pi over 4. So we have our x values. It's time to figure out our expected y values. This is a cosine graph, so we expect it to go 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1. We know our function is y equals 3 cosine of 2 times x plus pi over 4, plus 1. So we know our value of A is equal to 3. And we know our value of D is equal to 1. And that's a plus 1. It's going up 1. So when we figure out our y values, we have to take 1 times 3 and add 1. So we get 3 plus 1 is 4. 0 times 3, 0, plus 1 is 1. Negative 1 times 3 is negative 3, plus 1 is negative 2. 0 times 3 plus 1 is 1. 1 times 3 is 3, plus 1 is 4. So those are our expected values. You do have to check at least one. So I'll show a couple here. So depending on which one you chose to do, you can check your work. If we plug in this first value, we know that means we have to plug in negative pi over 4 in for x. So we're going to get 3 times the cosine of 2 times. Now, if I put a negative pi over 4 in here plus pi over 4, that becomes 0. And then we have plus 1. We know that the cosine of 0 is equal to 1. So we have 3 times 1 plus 1, which is equal to 4. So that one checked out. And maybe I'll do the midpoint. So in case anyone did that, we can check it together. So if we plug pi over 4 in for x, we're going to get 3 times the cosine of 2 times pi over 4 plus pi over 4 is 2 pi over 4, which reduces to pi over 2. And then we have plus 1. We see the 2's are going to cancel. So we have 3 times the cosine of pi plus 1. We know that the cosine of pi is equal to negative 1. So we have 3 times negative 1 is negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2. So that one checks out as well. So now we're ready to plot the 5 key points on our graph. Looking at our x values, we have to go from negative pi over 4 up to positive 3 pi over 4. So we've got a negative pi over 4 here. 0, we've got positive pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, and 3 pi over 4. Our y values go from negative 2 up to positive 4, so we can go by 1s. And now we're ready to plot our key points. We have negative pi over 4, 4, 0, 1, pi over 4, negative 2, 2 pi over 4, 1, and 3 pi over 4, 4. Connect everything with smooth curves. And there's our graph. Now we can check it with all the attributes that we first found. And we see the period needs to be pi. And from negative pi over 4 to positive 3 pi over 4. We've already done this subtraction. We know that that's pi, so that's good. The amplitude needs to be 3. So from the center line of the graph, we know we have to go a distance of 3 up to the max, or from the center line, we go a distance of 3 down to the min. The phase shift had to be negative pi over 4, so it's going left. We know that normally this first maximum of cosine would be on the y-axis, and instead it moved to the left by pi over 4, so that checks out. The vertical shift should be up by 1. We know this center line of cosine should be here on the x-axis, and we can see instead it's moved up by 1, so that checks out. And the range should be negative 2 to 4. Our smallest y value is negative 2. Our largest y value is 4, so that checks out as well.